I'm here with Candie Cooper, who has a great technique for dressing up your boots.
These boots were made for embellishing, Julie.
Yes, they were. And if we look at them, they're so fantastic. I particularly am in love with the gold fringe. I think that's amazing.
I love gold, anything gold. So these are really easy. Normally, like, we might use these dies to make cuff bracelets, but you can make boot jewelry too with them. So you ready to get rolling?
I am ready to get rolling.
Okay, so we're just using these dies, special dies.
I was gonna say, they look like border dies to me, or something like that, like I would use for a scrapbook page.
Totally. And we're gonna layer our little sandwich of material. I'm using leather today. And we're just gonna, we gotta go the right way.
Roll it on through it. I was gonna say, of course, if you don't have a die cut machine, you could use scissors, you could, you know, get it out. You can actually buy leather embellishments, obviously, that are already pre-cut.
Totally. And then what's gonna happen is that little shape is gonna pop right out of your leather.
Now, if you did not want to use leather, if you had a problem with that, what else could you use for your boots that's also gonna be durable?
Right, so you could use canvas. You could paint some canvas, mm-hmm. that would add some strength. There's vegan leathers now. Basically any heavy duty fabric, because these are gonna be on your feet. You know what I mean? So when we're finished, I've cut out a bunch of different shapes, but we're gonna start building the front part of the embellishment. So I can't leave well enough alone. So the first thing we're gonna do is add a little
paint. But here's the thing, what
paint.
I love about that is you're all about personalizing it. You're all about saying that you don't have to accept the way that something is or be searching for the perfect supply in the store for a million hours. You can just make it. And that's part of what creativity is to me.
Yeah, you said it perfectly. I love like just texture and all of that. And blending these colors and picking your favorite and just really, you know,
and now you're just using an enamel paint on top of the leather, because that's, again, for shoes, we want it to be durable.
Totally. And you can always, like, spray your finished painted pieces with something. But I'm just blotting this on. If you hate it, you
can... I can see your incredible painting technique.
like, eat your heart out, Rembrandt. So, and then to top it off, you might want to put some gold, or you can leave that alone. I've got one here that matches the other one, so I'm going to use that one for this piece. I painted them at the same time. That's always a good idea, too.
Oh, I was going to say, of course, because you're making one for each boot, so if you paint them at the same time, then you'll be using the same colors, the same amount of paint.
Right. So then you're going to layer up all your pieces. We're going to grab our trusty hole punch here.
But I noticed that already has a hole in the center of that flower.
It does, but I still like to crunch through it with this different size hole. So all the holes.
So you're just making a bigger hole.
Making it a little bit bigger, and it's consistent all the way through. Then we're going to use these rivets.
Okay.
These are just compression rivets.
And I will say, for anybody who's used to scrapbooking or paper crafting, rivets are like a way fancier eyelet.
Okay, that's perfectly put, because, and these, you know, the shaft on the bottom piece was a little bit, let's just take a look, that was a little long. We don't need all of that. So I just cut it with some wire cutters and then...
And that would have made it really loose, and instead you want a tight connection.
You want a tight fit this way, and you want the hole to be the same diameter as your rivet. Okay. So then I just put the little cap on the top.
So it seems like they snap together, but they're not actually really together.
It's not really all the way together. Now, you could use a plastic mallet. That would be safe. I have my little riveting hammer, so I'm just going to tap down on
that. You're working on a sandwich. This is like a soft surface plus your bench block.
Yep.
And
this is just to deaden the sound. You know, loud, whatever.
Oh, so this means you can do it while the baby's sleeping.
That's right. So then you would just keep adding your rivets and embellish pieces. And then I want to talk about this braid, because if we look at the boot, like, we need some way to get this guy. So this kind of needs to go up like that. So let's get that out of the way before we get glue all over our boots.
And I was gonna say, of course, if you didn't have cowboy boots, you could do this with little, like, motorcycle anklet boots. You could do this probably even with any little shoe that you wanted to. You could find a way to add that.
You absolutely could. And then you would just glue the other side, slide it on, fits. But that's not all.
Oh.
Do we have a second more?
I can
show you another idea.
Let's do it.
Okay, so now you've got your front side embellished. Let's talk about this little loop. This is made for hanging things off of, in my opinion.
I was gonna say, I thought it was for pulling the boot on, but now I understand. Pulling the boot on, that's not the point.
No. So I've got some more, like, just little leather here. And you can even like double this up. You can make this as like.
I was gonna say you could put some beads on there. You could add on. Oh, you know, you could put a little metal stamped piece on there that has somebody's name or something. This would actually, if you were having like a country wedding and your bridesmaids were wearing boots or something, which I know is kind of popular right now.
It really is.
A great bridesmaid gift to give them is little boot covers and dangles, and then they could all have matching boots, even though their boots themselves may be different.
Yes, yes, yes. I'm on board with this whole like kind of like country chic, like. Yeah. Cute. And these, like, I use spring colors for these because I think they would look really cute with short dresses and all that. But then I've got my little tassel and my charm. And then you're just going to knot this on.
You know what I like is that tassel adds so much movement so that when you're walking, you can really see,
walking?
You know,
I'll be on the dance floor.
When you're dancing and boogieing, you can really see that it could be a lot of fun.
Yeah, so then you just like let all that hang out. You can knot your ends. If we look at the finished one, you can just see how just it adds, just ties it all together.
I have one last question, which is, so you attach both ends of that, and then does this actually lift
straight off? It lifts
off.
Yeah, look at that, yes. So that just comes right off.
So it really does just lift right off, so that means you could have a whole wardrobe of these. So I think I'm looped around the tassel here. There you go. And I know you brought another beautiful sample here, and I love the gold fringe on this.
Thank you.
It's absolutely fantastic. This wonderful detailed feather that's on there, and it is built on a base that looks to me like an old belt.
I found that old belt in a thrift store, and I just cut it. It had the perfect patina to
that's
it.
Awesome.
I cut all that fringe and the feather with the die cutter. Little paint. Done.
Came together, no problem, all custom painted. And if you look at this, you can see how you can get those really delicate cuts. The rivets at the hard, it's soft hard, it's girly knot. Totally awesome, Candie.